Hey, you with the drip torch. Fire's pretty cool, isn't it? Well, actually, it's pretty hot. What you're looking at in that fire is the transfer of heat from burning material to unburned material. To really understand why fire occurs in the first place, we need to look at how heat transfers to and from the air and fuels. In this video, we'll discuss how heat is gained and lost through the three heat transfer processes: radiation, conduction, and convection. Heat energy is always on the move, and it naturally flows from hot to cold. The bigger the difference between the hot and cold temperatures, the faster the heat will transfer. You've experienced this process anytime you have touched something hot and felt your hand get warmer. The hotter the object, the faster your hand gets hot. How heat transfers depends on where it's coming from. Let's start with radiation. Radiation travels in waves that oscillate as they move. The distance between the waves of radiation can be measured, just like you can measure the distance between the tips of the waves on the ocean. Hot objects like the sun emit highly energetic radiation with short distances between waves, which we call shortwave radiation. Cooler objects emit lower energy radiation with lower wavelengths, which we call longwave radiation. The story of heat transfer on the Earth begins with the sun. The heat from the sun comes through the atmosphere in the form of shortwave radiation. After all, the sun is very hot. This radiation travels through the air without really heating it. When the shortwave radiation hits an object other than the air, the molecules in that object start to heat up and move around. Now, let's say we have an object, in this case a log, that's been heated by the sun through shortwave radiation. Its temperature is much, much cooler than the sun, so the log emits longwave radiation. And unlike shortwave radiation, longwave radiation easily heats many different types of air molecules. But that's not the only thing going on. The molecules of the log that are heated by the sun transfer heat through the log, like how a hot pan transfers heat to your hand. These warmed molecules in the log are also bumping into air molecules all around the log. Those air molecules then also warm. Both within the log and in the air next to it, this molecule-to-molecule transfer of heat through contact is called conduction. If the air over the log surface is warmer than the surrounding air, it's able to rise through the process of convection, which is the transfer of heat within a fluid like air and water. Warmer air rises and cooler air comes in to replace it. That cooler air is warmed and rises and, well, you get the idea. You can easily see this as the smoke rises from a fire. So let's zoom out and look at this process altogether. The sun heats the earth through radiation, the earth heats the air through conduction and radiation, and the warmed air heats even more air above through convection. Fire is also a source of heat, similar to the sun because, well, the sun is fire after all, and fire's hot, right? When you have heat from a fire, it can travel in straight lines and heat fuels, or your skin, through radiation. Heat transfers from outside to the inside of fuel through conduction, and heat transfers in the air around the fire through convection. All three forms of heat transfer are happening all the time with fire and without fire. Something else to consider is that all objects are not created equal in the way that they absorb and transfer heat. Take this landscape, for example. What you see are places that are flat and steep, covered in trees or grass, with black rocks or white sand. Each of these surfaces heats up differently, causing the air to move. For example, light objects reflect more radiation and heat up more slowly, whereas dark objects absorb more radiation and reflect less, so they heat up quicker. Also, bodies of water gain and lose heat slower than land, so that during the day, they are often cooler than the land, while at night, they're often warmer than the land. So how does the Earth cool down? The Earth emits longwave radiation 24 hours per day, but it only receives shortwave solar radiation for around 12 hours per day. Once the sun sets, the source of the heating to the planet's surface goes away. Then, as the Earth emits longwave radiation off to space, the surface of the Earth cools down. This cold nighttime surface then conducts heat away from the air closest to it, which reduces the air temperature. This explains why the coldest part of a 24-hour period is just after sunrise, since at that time the Earth has been without the heat source of the sun for the longest. Also, see how the hottest part of the day in this figure is several hours after the solar radiation is at its peak? It's not uncommon for the fire to be most active in this time. We call this afternoon peak in temperature and fire behavior the critical burn period, and it's a good idea to take 5 minutes before the critical burn period to assess the fire environment. When in complex terrain, aspect impacts fire behavior because of the difference in sun angle at different times of the day, which affects the fuel moisture. So heat. Pretty cool, right? I mean, hot. Next time you're outside, see if you can find the three heat transfer processes: radiation, conduction, and convection. Next time you're on a fire, see if you can notice how heat transfer from the fire and the sun are affecting fire behavior.